Growing up on the river, it was very much a natural resource. People used it for their livelihoods, digging clams, for recreation, for fishing and boating. It was very much a use-based resource. It's something that really connects people. And in lots of ways, everything from your drinking water to here in Ipswich in particular, the economy. We're here at the mouth of the river, and Ipswich, back in the early 1600s, was the second largest community in the United States, if you can believe that. And the reason it was settled was because of the fisheries resources. The town's original name, Agawam, is a native term for places where fishes of passage resorted. If we can get the fish back, that means we have a really healthy system. And with things like dam removal and restocking, we're really hopeful to restore that former glory.
Our river restoration program has, for a number of years, focused on improving the river's function and habitat connections throughout the watershed. So we are hoping to better connect the river for the fish and wildlife that live in it, and also restore some of the river function and the river processes that make it such a good place for those things to live. One of the main things that I've been working on for the past few years is trying to improve habitat connection and flow through structures on the river. So the things we're looking at are dams and bridges and culverts. So removing man-made ponds along the river allows fish and other aquatic wildlife to move up and down to places they need to be at certain times of the year or during certain river conditions.
Dams on the river block the movement of creatures that are naturally supposed to be able to move back and forth in those sections. They also trap pollutants and such.
We've been working closely with the folks at Bostic and other partners, state, federal, and local partners, to first investigate the feasibility and now working to remove the dam.
As an owner of the dam, I think, you know, removal is the best option. This is an aging dam. It's been here for, you know, possibly 100 years, and owning dams requires upkeep, and we're at a point now where we're going to have to invest some significant money in the dam, and the dam serves no purpose to Bostic. No one I've ever talked to has ever seen any of the uses of damming up the river. There is a raceway off to the side that I imagine had paddle mills at one point, and that still exists on site, but we've never used the power of the river here and don't know anyone that has.
We hope that in removing that dam, we will reduce flooding risk for the folks immediately upstream, reduce the risk during a failure of the road and the people that live downstream, and also open up fishing, open up recreational opportunities. So we see it as a big community benefit along with the wildlife and ecosystem benefits that would come with it.
I think it's going to benefit the community, and I think it's going to be a much more scenic river, and it's pretty exciting to think about a river running through that people can pass through on kayaks or, you know, fish in shallow, bubbling brook. I think that's just a nice thing to imagine.
The sooner that we can get rid of the Bostic Dam, the better. The Ipswich Mills Dam, which is at such a critically important location on the Ipswich River, right at the head of the tide, I'm hoping that in the future, we'll see the removal of that dam too.
When I think about restoration and resilience, I'm thinking about how to remove constraints that we've put there and allow the ecosystem and the wildlife to do what it does best, which is adapt.
Water is the most important resource in our lives and in our society, and people often take it for granted. Without the Ipswich River, we would have no communities. We'd have no business, we'd have no economy. So it's our goal and hope that the Ipswich River can continue to provide that lifeblood of our communities for centuries to come.
To highlight some of the successes, the salt marsh and the water quality here is so much better than it was. There are signs that the ecology of the region can recover if we can devote ourselves to helping it do that, to putting efforts into restoration. That will benefit not only the ecology of the region, but it will benefit us.
Just to exemplify that point, right behind us was closed to shellfishing for over a century. And just this year alone, $1 million worth of clams will be harvested right behind us. So we're really excited. We can't wait for it to happen.